Hello everybody, this is Reid Duke. Welcome to my first Aether Revolt Kaladesh draft here on channelfireball.com. My opening pack has two of the best uncommons in the set in other Untethered Express, which is actually my pick for the best non-rare card to start a draft with, and Pacification Array, which is also excellent. There's really not that much to say about this pick beyond the fact that I've identified Untethered Express as one of my favorite cards to start a draft with. If this wasn't here, I'd take Pacification Array. I also really like Aether Chaser, Druid of the Cowl, and that's about it from this pack. Wow, Winding Constrictor is also one of the best uncommons in the set. It goes reasonably well with Untethered Express. It certainly would also be reasonable to take Thopter Arrest, since Thopter Arrest is an excellent card and is monocolor, and white is even a good color to go with vehicles. So I would definitely not fault someone for making that pick. In fact, it's probably actually the best expert level pick would be to take Thopter Arrest and be a little bit more flexible and open in terms of what colors to go into. However, I really like the black-green color combination. It's my favorite color combination, and I virtually never pass a Winding Constrictor if I can help it. So at this stage of the draft, I think I'm just gonna take the Winding Constrictor and hope to be black-green counters matters type deck. All right, so Peacekeeper, Peacewalker, Colossus would be cool if I had started with Untethered Express and Thopter Arrest for a white vehicles type deck. Shock, of course, is just really solid bread and butter card. And if I want to stay on color, Aether Poisoner probably gets the nod over Verdant Automaton. So this is an interesting pick between taking a card that's good for my deck, but clearly a notch worse in power level than some of the other cards in the pack. It would be fairly extreme to take Aether Poisoner over Shock here, though not necessarily wrong. I think this is a pretty interesting one. I'm going to take the Poisoner. It's hard to go three colors in this format. It's not that easy to go, say, red, green, splashing black if I wanted to still use my Winding Constrictor. So if I was to take the Shock, it's almost like I have Winding Constrictor and I have Shock, and they're not very likely to go in the same deck. I just have to choose which direction to go. And I think Aether Poisoner is good enough that I'd rather just take the on-color card. And this is perfect to get Daring Demolition here. It's the best card in the pack and goes perfectly with what I'm going for. All right, Heroic Intervention is a rare that is approximately the same power level as a common. This is just a playable trick type card, but definitely nothing exciting. I'm not going to take that here. I think I'd be more inclined to take Unbridled Growth, which can trigger Revolt and actually can mana fix if I get a gold uncommon that I really want to splash later in the draft. So among not that many other exciting options, I'm going to take the Unbridled Growth. Aerial Modification is a powerful card, but definitely not what I'm going for at this point. Okay, I'm going to take Lifecraft Cavalry over Implement of Ferocity. These are both strong cards that fit really well in my deck, and I'd probably rather have one of each than two of either one, but I find Lifecraft Cavalry a card that you really, really do want to have in this deck, so it would be a shame for me to take the Implement of Ferocity and never get another chance at my really powerful top-end card. Cruel Finality is also a card that would very likely make my deck, but I think the power level on these two cards is higher, and they fit better with the plus one counter theme. Okay, Natural Obsolescence is a card that I'm happy to main deck one copy of. Silkweaver Elite, sort of just filler. I guess Verdant Automaton is also filler. I'd rather take Silkweaver Elite earlier in the draft. Green black can sometimes have a weakness to flying creatures, so even though Triggering Revolt is neither that easy nor that powerful on Silkweaver Elite, it's still a creature that can trade against your opponent's Windrake or anything like that and just keep you alive a little longer. There's another Silkweaver Elite, sure. Renegade's Getaway is pretty bad. It can be like a fringe sideboard card. I wonder if it's better for me to take one of these middle three cards that's slightly more powerful. I think I'll just keep sticking with the black and green cards. Maybe incentivize my opponents to my left to take cards of other colors. It's a close pick between Highspire Infusion and Verdant Automaton. The infusion, I would say, is going to be better if I wind up with a lot of energy sinks, but so far that's not the way things are shaping up, and I think I do want one Verdant Automaton in my deck. Oh, there's the second one, so I wish I could go back and take the Highspire Infusion, but that's not a card that I'm really gonna miss terribly. Well, I'm pretty thrilled with how Pack 1 went. I got, two of the absolute best cards, best non-rare cards, and then I got a removal spell, and I have a pretty solid framework mana curve of creatures, so pretty much everything you hope for in a first pack of a draft. Wow, this card's really, really strong. Solemn Recruit. But it's very much not the deck I'm drafting. Similarly, Renegade Rallier would be like kind of cool if I decide I want to splash and be Abzan. I think I'm just going to take a Lifecraft Cavalry here. This card is really good. It's going to be a great addition to my deck, and I don't have to ruin a good thing that I've got going on here. Tempting to take the more powerful off-color cards, but I'm just going to stick to my guns. Monstrous Onslaught, really powerful card, especially having two Lifecraft Cavalries and an Untethered Express. I can really make a lot of cool things happen with this card. That's a slam dunk. And Druid of the Cowl is really nice, given that my curve's starting to get a little bit high. At other stages or of the draft or with other decks, I could see taking one of these other cards over the Druid, but for right now, the Druid's the best card in the pack for me, rather than taking a third 5-drop. This pack really has nothing that I'd be inclined to put in my deck, so I'm probably going to take something that I don't want to play against, like a Destructive Tampering, Merchant's Dockhand, Aerial Modification. Not sure what the best counter draft is here. Suppose there are some ways the draft could turn where I would wind up playing Crackdown Construct. It is good with a crew one vehicle, but it's just a little bit too fancy of a card for my tastes. Just take this Destructive Tampering. Aid from the Cowl, this card is pretty bad. You have to trigger it way too many times before it can replace itself enough that you're really happy playing with it. I'm just going to take Implement of Ferocity. Guess Night Market Aeronaut is an okay filler card for this style of deck. So there's not really that much that I'm missing right now. There's not anything that I'm really holding my breath waiting to get. I have two removal spells. They're a little on the expensive side, so I could use something like a Prey Upon or I guess the time for getting something as good as a Fatal Push is probably past. But, you know, any kind of cheap removal to round things out would be nice. But mostly I'm just feel like I'm on the right track and want to keep picking up, you know, solid creatures and keeping the card quality high. This interesting pick between Consulate, Dreadnought, Natural Obsolescence, and Unbridled Growth. I already have one Natural Obsolescence, so I wouldn't really main deck a second, but it's a really strong sideboard card. That said, I'm probably more inclined to take one of these other two cards. Consulate Dreadnought is a very powerful card, but not necessarily what I'm going for here. You'll notice that most of my two drops have only one power, so it's kind of hard to crew this. I guess I'll just take Unbridled Growth. It is good with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 revolt cards. Yeah, that's the pick, I think. Fourth Bridge Patrol for my sideboard, I guess. I actually don't mind one copy of Resourceful Return in my deck, but I might prefer Aether Herder here. I'm a little light on the 4-drop slot, and I could get some more energy. Energy matters stuff, especially in Kaladesh, where energy is more prevalent. Perilous Predicament's actually decent. Counter Draft Leave in the Dust, and one more of these for my sideboard. Sure, another Fourth Bridge Patrol. If I play against a deck with a million 2/1 creatures, I could bring those in. Yeah, I pretty much just need to pick up a couple more good creatures and I'll have a nice deck on my hands. I'm likely to play, I think, 16 lands because I have a Druid of the Cowl and a few cantrips. Though my deck is sort of mana hungry with one or two Verdant Automatons and some expensive stuff. Well, this is just great, getting Bristling Hydra. I mean, if it's a on-color rare, it fits with the plus minus one counter theme. It puts me in great position to use energy cards if I get some later in the draft. You know, I guess I'm not that likely to wheel a tune with the Aether from this pack, but it's possible. Anyway, definitely slamming the Bristling Hydra here. And then, wow, this goes well with the plus minus one counter theme. Underhanded Design's also appealing. We all know how good Renegade Freighter is. So, yeah. Interesting pick here. Let's see exactly what this does go well with. Two Verdant Automatons, Winding Constrictor, Night Market Aeronaut, Bristling Hydra, Untethered Express. You know, I think as cool and fun as this card would be, I think it's probably just right for me to take the Freighter. And I don't have quite enough artifacts to make Underhanded Designs as good as I want it to be. Wow, Aetherworks Marvel, huh? I mean, that card's hard to use. It was a good card in Triple Kaladesh, but it's harder to use now with two packs that have less energy than normal. Appetite for the Unnatural is approximately same power level as Natural Obsolescence, and I don't really need a second. Duned Operative's quite strong, so I could take that just as a solid 2-drop. Yeah, the Marvel is probably a little too fancy. Although, you know, it does... The generating energy effect is kind of powerful in Limited compared to Constructed. Like, you can just trade off creatures and get energy. It's good with Unbridled Growth and Implement of Ferocity. I don't think it would be unreasonable to take the Marvel here. And it would be really fun. But I think if I just want to win, I should take Doomed Operative. 'Hunt the Weak, that's perfect. Actually, Rush of Vitality is excellent, excellent card as well. But I do think Hunt the Weak is better for me. Elegant Edgecrafters over Die Young. Yeah, I think one Elegant Edgecrafters will make my deck. I'll be happy about that. Ornamental Courage, Thriving Rats, Takedown. Probably Thriving Rats is fine for me. Ooh, I actually really like to have one Fortuitous find. But Takedown is also an excellent sideboard card, so which of these is going to be better for me? You know, I think Fortuitous is fine. I think I'm going to put that in my main deck. I like that card a lot. High Spire Artisan's great. Hazardous Conditions also pretty good for me. I think I like the Artisan better. And probably not playing any of these cards, but Ballista Charger is likely the best of them. Or the most likely to make my deck, I should say. Wow, Underhand Designs Wheels. It's really, I'd be stretching to put this in my deck. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, I guess you can count Aether Poisoner and High Spire Artisan. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I mean, that's not really enough. I guess I'll take it, though, because there's nothing else for me. If I get, like, two more artifacts, then maybe I'll play the underhand designs. Get a little greedy. As it is, which of these cards is not going to make my deck? Maybe second Verdant Automaton. Maybe Night Market Aeronaut or Aether Herder, Perilous Predicament. Ornamental Courage is decent. I have two Trample Vehicles that it goes well with. But I want to keep the creature count high. I guess I'll take that. I'll decide later whether or not it's going to make my main deck. I guess I don't want anyone demolishing my trains. Yeah, I think unfortunately I have my non-creature slots locked up pretty well with these expensive removal spells and the vehicles and the cheap cantrips. So I'm not really going to be looking for something like Ornamental Courage. I like one Disenchant. I like Fortuitous Find. This could be okay. I think I'm more inclined to leave it on the sideboard and bring it in. So probably just going to add either the Herder or the Aeronaut. And of the two, the Herder is probably a little stronger. I guess that's sort of one more artifact with the Underhanded Designs, but I don't think I got there in terms of having enough. I think I'm going to run this with 16 lands. Pretty even split, maybe 9-7. Yeah, so I'm very happy with this deck. I mean, I only got one rare in Bristling Hydra, but my uncommons are really strong. I have a nice curve. Got some removal spells. I definitely am pleased with how this draft went. I think I have a good chance to do well. So last thing I'm going to do, as always, is take a screenshot. Then I'm going to save my deck and join a match.